You know, I can't stop thinking about this movie, Uncle Tom. If you haven't seen it, you need to see it.
Let's pop over to it.
Let's talk about it. So this movie just came out. Larry Elder did it. He's the director, and he wrote most of it and did a lot of the research and brought a lot of people on to do this movie. And it shows the black conservative side of things. And let me just read it here. It says, what does it say there? It says, a collection of intimate interviews with some of America's most provocative black conservative thinkers. Uncle Tom takes a different look at being black in America. And not only that, it shows the history of civil rights from a different perspective that I mean, I wasn't alive through it, you know, and I don't know that history. And it, honestly, it's not taught. I had to learn it through this. And I think everyone needs to see this, whether or not you're Democrat, Republican. It doesn't matter.
Well, this is my challenge to anybody who claims to support Black Lives Matter to watch this.
I agree.
Because my question is, if you believe that Black Lives Matter, then what about these individuals?
Right.
You know, these people who are speaking up and speaking out, who want to be heard. Do their lives matter? Do what they think? I think 100%.
Yeah, absolutely.
I think Black Lives Matter includes conservatives,
right,
and their perspective. Now, I think they might be more likely to say all lives matter, and Trump and MAGA.
Probably.
One dude's got a shirt that says conservative thug on it,
mm-hmm,
and like a MAGA hat.
Right.
But I think, you know, my thing has always been, you know, I want to hear what you have to say. I want to try and be respectful.
But they're all successful. They all work hard. They all talk about it. They all talk about being accountable for your own actions. You know, talk about things that when you see the emotions that are triggered and people get all upset and angry, there's money in that. You know, and as sad and you know, bad, and I wouldn't say bad to say, but it's because it's the truth that they're banking on this. You know, it's like it sells. They talk about all of this. You know, there's a lot of it that they go into. But the most important thing about this is you learn the history of what they went through from slavery to now. And man, I am impressed. I am humbled from the stories that you hear.
Frederick Douglass.
I learned more about him from this documentary, and it is an incredible journey that he went through.
And Booker T. Washington.
Many of them, yes. And the stories that they talk about, and the civil rights movements that they were a part of, a lot of these people were a part of it. They were standing there with all these people making these rules or making these laws, putting these laws into place. They're the reason why we're more free now than ever, especially the black community.
But everything that came after the civil rights movement,
yes,
because of the fight of people like Martin Luther King,
right,
we got rights for everybody.
Absolutely.
And you know, from that fight, we've actually expanded in many different ways. It really, really, really blows my mind.
Go.
The people who complain about this country when we literally just had a landmark Supreme Court ruling protecting the LGBTQ community.
Right.
It's like every chance given to prove how progressive and welcoming this country is, we do.
Right.
And they still complain about it.
Yep.
No, not enough, because it's never enough. We've granted rights to literally everybody.
Yep, exactly.
You know, there's it's not perfect, okay, and we're always improving. I get it, but it's like whenever an issue comes up, and they're like, "Hey, what about this group?" We're like, "Okay, well, yep. What about this group?" You got it.
Yeah,
and they're like, "Well, I'm still mad.
We're running out of things to be mad about. Like, what are we be angry about? Well, why don't you work on your own life?
Yeah.
Why don't you further your own dreams? Why don't you focus on yourself? No one wants to do that." And that's something that I've been talking about, being accountable for your own actions. That's why I'm doing constant delving into these critical thinkers of the greatest critical thinkers of our day, because I want to be knowledgeable about what's going on in the world. I want to know what I'm talking about when I'm sitting on a show with you.
Yeah.
When I'm talking in front of how many people we got? 30,000 people here. Ooh. You know, it's like I don't want to be ignorant in the ideas that I was once. So this documentary, everybody needs to see it, because it shows, it talks about being accountable. We need to stop confusing holding people accountable for their actions with racism. And I see that happening a lot nowadays. And that's a huge issue.
And
people don't want to be accountable. They want to blame others. Oh, no. It's society's fault. It's a systemic thing. you know, when you look about it, it's like, okay, I could see the things that you're talking about, the systemic issues, and they talk about it in here. And it started long ago, actually, when the civil rights movement happened. There was a, you know, welfare. They talk about welfare. They talk about Planned Parenthood.
These are the dangerous conversations for YouTube.
I don't care.
That's why
this needs to be said. People need to talk about this.
But that's why I challenge people to watch the documentary.
Absolutely.
These are the things that will get you banned. No joke. No joke. When you talk about the structure of the nuclear family.
Yep.
Black Lives Matter saying they want to, you know, break it apart. I've heard this. I need to fact check this one. So definitely fact check this one for sure.
Down with the patriarchy. It's one of their number one things they're trying to bring down.
Traditional family. These are things that are key indicators of success. And I have to wonder why it is that, you know, many of these progressive activists come from families that are well off and traditionally structured, and then go and advocate for other people to break their families apart.
You're right.
And to not have those families.
That was a democratic thing that was going on back in the day.
And listen.
Long time ago.
When it comes to welfare, mm-hmm. It's simple. An age-old adage. Teach a man a fish, feed him for a day.
Yep.
Feed a man a fish, feed him for a day. Teach a man a fish, feed him for the rest of his life.
Thomas Sowell talks about how slaves couldn't read. They didn't want to spread knowledge. And in 50 years after, more than 50% of all African Americans in America could read. They were literate. And he said that was, historians should talk about that and how amazing that is because of what they went through to get to where they are. And that was 50 or 100, I don't know how long ago, 70 years ago now, from 50 years from when the Emancipation Proclamation, I don't have my dates exactly in line right now, but he's an amazing man too. Thomas Sowell, man.
Dude's a genius.
How is he not, how is he not being idolized?
I idolize him.
Hold on. No, you're not black, though.
Why isn't he on CNN?
I'll tell you why.
Hold on. No. I just want to finish what I'm saying here. How is he not idolized over Snoop Dogg?
Yeah.
I love Snoop. He's got some flows that I can jam on, you know, but I don't go to Snoop Dogg for my critical thinking thoughts. But Thomas Sowell is an incredible, like, critical thinker. He's been around. He was in the civil rights movement. He was there. He was standing there.
Thomas Sowell is so much more than just this conversation, too.
You're absolutely
right. He's a brilliant
genius,
just yes. In general.
Absolutely.
He comments on things in politics and culture on so many different spaces.
Yep.
And the economy.
Yeah.
The dude is the one of the best, the smartest we've got.
I mean, it doesn't matter race aside. He is one of the top critical thinkers America has ever produced, ever. And I mean that.
And they and who do they end up putting on, you know, CNN?
Jay-Z. I'm not joking.
And what happens when Kanye West speaks up? Mentally ill,
yeah.
Right.
Bipolar,
and
manic.
He literally said, "We got to think for ourselves. We can't let people control us because we're emotional and we're proud."
You know what this is?
And that's how is that craziness?
You know what's going on?
Hmm.
The Democrats have always taken the black community for granted.
Yeah.
And Donald Trump reached out.
Yep.
He's not perfect.
Yep.
He's at around, I think he's averaging like in some polls really high, some polls kind of low, but he's better than he was, almost double where he was in the aggregate.
Yep.
So we had 8% last time. He comes out and he does all these events. He brings on many high profile, black influencers.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden now, he's nearly doubling his approval among the black community.
I mean, it makes sense. He's done so much. Jobs among the black community were at an all-time low under his
president. All-time high.
Jobs. Unemployment, right, was at an all-time low.
Well, that's
like,
for everybody.
Ivanka Trump pushed the Treasury to push, like, I think it was $10 billion into minority schooling.
Yeah.
Because they know schooling is number one. It should be priority. Why are we policing around the world instead of going to our, you know, minority groups, not even
our
minorities,
our own cities,
the people that really need our help, pumping it into those schools to help everybody learn.
And when Trump tried to pull our troops out of Afghanistan,
what did they do?
They blocked it. Everybody blocked it.
Why did they block it? Do you
even
know?
I don't know why.
It's
a war machine, baby.
But what was their official reasoning, though? What
I
did they
know.
Say? They didn't. Even,
I have no idea.
Okay, because I would like to. I want to know the reason why.
They wanted an inquiry into Russia's putting a bounty on American soldiers, or something, and that, you know, other stupid nonsense.
Okay,
you know what, man, the Democrats did. I feel like they've offered nothing to the cities and entirely. These cities are just trash heaps.
Before we move on, Lydia, what did you have to say about it? You had something to say there.
Okay, well, it actually gets me pretty heated that they don't actually care about the people who escaped from slavery and then chose to learn to read and
Frederick
make
Douglass.
Something of themselves. Exactly. That really ticks me off because those people work their tails off.
Yeah.
But no one ever talks about them because that's not what they want to model. They don't want to talk about personal responsibility. They don't want to talk about education and learning to read.
Exactly.
They want to talk about victimhood because they want control.
Yep.
I'm convinced it's about control.
What's happening is you ended up with Trump actually reaching out saying, I'm going to offer you something. And then he literally said, what have you got to lose?
That's true.
All of a sudden, the Democrats started realizing like, uh-oh, people actually care about black lives.
Yeah.
Black lives matter.
Yep.
And this is a threat to them.
He put...
to their politics.
He did an executive order to pump $10 million into historically black-only colleges. Not that they're black only, but it's like historically they've been
yeah.
you know, black colleges, and he's pumping money into these places. Trump is. You see, these are the things that I'm.
That's why they have to call him racist.
I know, exactly.
They have to. Thanks for checking out this clip from the Timcast IRL podcast. We do the show live Monday through Friday at 8 p.m. If you want to catch the full show, tune into this channel, subscribe, hit the like button, or check us out on iTunes and Spotify, and we will soon have this podcast up for free on all podcast platforms. Thanks for hanging out, and we'll see you all in the next episode.